Hi guys, I was just live on TikTok for the first time and I went shopping and I was showing the stuff to the people there, so I thought I can quickly come to Instagram and I can do the same lesson with you, maybe a bit in a different way. So I have this stuff on the floor. This might be a bit repetitive because I've done this before and usually I end up buying the same things, but you know, there will always be something new. So before I begin, I want to let you know that, yeah, usually when you see my Instagram videos, you will see that I write on them the names of the stuff that you are learning the names of and all of that. But here, because I'm live, I won't be able to write the names. Hi, everyone. Hi, Dina. Hi, Robin. So hi, everyone. So I'm just going to say the names for now. And later on, I can sit down and write everything under the video. I can share it as an IGTV, okay? So yalla, خلونا نبلش. Let's begin. So كنت عم بشتري غراض من السوبرماركت. I was buying stuff from the supermarket. كل شيء على الأرض. Everything is on the floor. So I will start showing you. يلا. And if you know, immediately tell me, okay? So هيدي أنينة, okay? Again, on its own, the word. I'm happy that you caught it too. So on its own, it's 11:30 here at night. So yalla, let's begin. On its own, it's annine. It has a te marbuta, okay? But we don't say annine. No, we say annine. What's the difference? Because when I say annine, it means bottle. But when I say annine, ومنلفظ التي مربوطة, and we pronounce the te marbuta, it means a bottle of. It's always the case when you pronounce the te marbuta. So it's something of something else, okay? And most of the times, think of it as it's a noun plus noun. So for example, annine, if it's on its own. But if I want to say a bottle of water, I say anninet mai. Annine mai, غلط. Okay? Anninet mai. You have to pronounce the te marbuta. Anninet mai, يعني a bottle of water. كيف منقول soup بالعربي؟ مين بيعرف؟ شو يعني soup بالعربي؟ يلا, I'll wait. I'm not gonna say it. I'm sure at least one of you knows it. شو يعني soup بالعربي؟ يعني شوربة. برافو دينا. I knew you're gonna be the one who says it. Okay? شوربة. شوربة يعني soup. شوربة. Soup يعني شوربة. شو كمان في؟ هون عندنا كيس باستا. بس مش باستا عادية. برافو طه. مش باستا عادية. It's not regular باستا. هيدي باستا معمولة من عدس. معمولة من. It means made of. I'm saying معمولة because I'm just assuming pasta is feminine. I don't know because it's not even an Arabic word. Okay? So if it's masculine, I would say معمول من. We can't know if it's masculine and feminine because it's not an Arabic word. بس معمول من means made of. معمول من عدس. عدس يعني lentils. صح. ميرسي لينا. So هيدي باستا معمولة من عدس. إيه lentil pasta. It's really good. I like to buy it a lot because it's better than eating pasta. So it makes me feel less guilty. And it's made 100% من عدس. 100% يعني 100%. 100% 100 in the 100. 100% معمولة من عدس. Okay. عندنا هون أفوكا. نفس الشيء منقول أفوكا أو أفوكادو. Okay. It's not like it has a special word in Arabic. Peach بالعربي يعني دراق. منكتبها دراق. It's written with a qaf, but we don't really pronounce the qaf. The Druze pronounce the qaf in Lebanon. But generally speaking, it's very common to not pronounce the qaf in Levantine Arabic or in the Lebanese accent. So دراق. I'm not saying دراق. It's دراق. You have to do that pause in the end. So هون في دراق. كيف منقول shrimps بالعربي باللبناني؟ كيف منقول shrimps؟ قلوا لي شو يعني shrimps بالعربي؟ حدا بيعرف؟ The neighbors are being noisy. The walls as if don't exist here. Okay. شو؟ apricots. مشمش. Okay. مشمش is apricots. Hi, Levon. That's my friend. شو؟ كيف منقول؟ خوخ is the prune. Yeah, prune, like the blue purpley one. That's hoch. Okay, mishmush is the orange one. So in Lebanon we call raides. Okay, so look at Putros. He wrote kraides. Yes, it's written as kraides بالفصحى ق. Okay, but in Lebanon we don't pronounce the qaf. We don't pronounce the qaf. We say raides. Okay, raides. يعني shrimps. Yeah, say out loud with me. Don't just sit there. Yeah, I'm listening. No. Say it out loud so that your brain memorizes it fast. And even if you write it, it's better. Even if you're not seeing it, you could still write it. So it becomes part of your physiology. You memorize it faster. Okay? So, shrimps, يعني rice. Chips. I bought another bag as well, so that's really bad. So, just say chips for the chips. Okay? So not in the British way where they call it crisps, no, chips. Okay, هيدا خبز. Okay, خبز يعني bread. يلا, let me explain this one second. So خبز يعني bread. خبز أسمر يعني brown bread. خبز أسمر. أسمر يعني brunette. Somebody with black hair or brown hair, we just refer to them as أسمر. Let me put it in the, because this one really breaks very fast. I'll put it in the fridge. رح حطه بالفريزر. أنا عادة بحط الخبز بالفريزر. I usually put the bread in the freezer. Okay, so كنت عم بقول. Actually, I wanted to show you something, but it's fine. Just imagine it with me. So خبز أسمر يعني brown bread. كمان إذا شاب, for example, if it's a guy, you say شاب أسمر. Okay, بنت. سمرة بالمؤنث. In the feminine form, it's سمرة. So أسمر سمرة يعني brunette. But when it's brown bread, I say like a brunette bread. That's why we call it خبز أسمر. And I'm not saying خبز سمرة. لا, لأنه خبز مذكر. It's masculine. Okay, so خبز أسمر. What was I going to say? And it was a bag of bread. So I can say كيس خبز. مش غلط. بس عادة بلبنان ما منقول كيس خبز. We don't usually say كيس خبز. We say ربطت خبز. Pronounce it with me. ربطت خبز. Okay? ربطت خبز يعني a bag of bread. And we just use ربطة for bread only. We don't usually use it for anything else. Just خبز. ربطت خبز. And if you just want to say a bag of bread without specifying bread, you can say بدي ربطة. ربطة. عمول معروف. Please. Okay? And this is سل. Hi, Nabil. If anyone wants to learn Fusha, you have to go to Nabil's classes. He's really good. You can also use it for dark, for example, when someone has black hair. Yes, thank you, Dina. And also for sugar, we say سكر أسمر. Okay? Now, هيدا celery بلبنان, in the Lebanese accent, we pronounce it كرفس. كرفس, okay? كرفس. هون عنا, يلا tell me, is it منقول علبة تون أو علبة تون؟ أيها, I just explained to you something about the تي مربوطة and how we pronounce it and when we don't pronounce it. شو؟ Thank you, Dina, for writing it. Guys, just check what Dina is writing. It's really helpful if you check at the same time. Thank you so much. So on its, yes, bravo. So it's علبة تون. On its own, it's علبة. When I'm just saying box or a can, we pronounce it علبة. I don't say علبة, that would be wrong. But when I want to say a box of or a can of something, I have to pronounce the تي مربوطة. We call this grammatically the إضافة. الإضافة. So whenever you have a noun plus noun, pronounce the تي مربوطة. يعني if I say علبة تون, غلط. علبة تون, صح, برافو. جازمين, روزي, عندينا. So, علبة تون. كيف منقول chewing gum بالعربي؟ منقول علكة in the singular, علكة بالمفرد. In the plural, it's علك. It's not إلكة. علكة. علكة. I've been living in the UK for 10 years, yes. So, علكة. With the تي مربوطة, that you don't pronounce. بالجمع, in the plural, it's علك. 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 two syllables. So, علكي, chewing gum. علك, بالجمع, chewing gums. هيدي شو؟ أناناس. Okay, we will not say pineapple or anything. Ananas in French or in Arabic, even we call it ananas. شو بقول؟ أنينة أناناس or أنينة أناناس. Look, look, Nabil is being like really polite and saying I'm the best teacher. He is the best teacher. But I'm not gonna say what we tell each other. So Nabil is from Yemen. When we first met, just so you see how different sometimes accents can be. When we first met, we weren't used to each other's accents. So a lot of times when he used to say something, I would say what? And when I say something, هو بيقول شو؟ مش عم نفهم عبعد. Okay, but so then we got used to it, which means like now when I speak to Nabil or we don't use Fusha ever just because it's the common language. No, we don't even think that each one of us is speaking a different Arabic. Each one in an Arabic country speaks their own dialect and the other responds with their dialect. And that's how we understand and speak to each other. It's always the case, okay? Except for the swear words. They can be different. Nabil knows. Okay, so هيدي أنينة أناناس أو أنينة أناناس. ليكو ليفون ثانك يو يلا اكتبهم. So هيدي أنينة أناناس. لازم نلفظ التاء المربوطة. ليه؟ لأنه it's إضافة. We have a bottle of. So فينا نقول عصير أناناس. عصير يعني جوس. عصير ع عين عصير عصير أناناس. So هيدي أنينة عصير أناناس. يلا say it out loud with me. هيدي أنينة. هيدي أنينة عصير أناناس. هون عندي 3 in 1 نسكافيه. 3 in 1 كيف منقول 3 in 1 بالعربي؟ منقول 3 بواحد. 3 بواحد. It's usually B but we abbreviate it. We never say 3 B واحد. We're saying 3 بواحد. يلا قولوها معي. 3 بواحد. 3 in 1. 3 بواحد. So هون عندنا حليب. حليب يعني milk. حليب. And how do we say free in Arabic? It's not free as in when you're free or you have your freedom. I mean to say free as in without. First of all, free as in freedom. That's حر بالمذكر. حر. وبالمؤنث حرة. مثلا أنا حرة. I am free. أنا حرة. Okay. Hi Joey. أنا حرة. Okay, but this one I can't say حليب حر من اللاكتوز. That would be wrong. Okay, so in this case, free as in free from is بلا بدون خالي. That's in فصحى. Okay, so my friend ليفون wrote خالي. خالي من. You usually say خالي من اللاكتوز. But in Lebanon, when I want to go to the supermarket and I want to buy milk without lactose, and I buy without lactose as if I don't eat all the cheeses in the world and stuff. But anyways, it's better than nothing. I'm not gonna go to the Kenji, which is the shop owner. Thank you so much, Zina, that you're writing him. And say, بدي حليب خالي من اللاكتوز. I will say, بدي حليب بلا لاكتوز. بلا, يعني without, بلا لاكتوز. أو بدون like لاكتوز. أو حتى من دون. من دون لاكتوز. I would say بلا لاكتوز. حليب بلا لاكتوز. أو حليب بدون لاكتوز. Okay. بلا لاكتوز or بدون. Thank you so much. بدون لاكتوز for writing them. Okay. هيدي. هون عندنا فليفلة. We have. I just bought two types of فليفلة. Okay. So. هيدي فليفلة. مش حرة. حرة. As in hot. It's not as in hot, it's hot. No, as in it burns your mouth. That kind of hot. هيدي فليفلة مش حرة. It's not hot. هيدي فليفلة حلوة. حلوة. Yes, the كنجي is the كين is the mini market. The كنجي is the guy who sells it. Okay? So, anyways, going back to this. So, هيدي فليفلة حلوة حلوة يعني sweet بس حلوة كمان يعني beautiful okay in the feminine. هيدي فليفلة حلوة بس هيدي فليفلة حرة كتير حر yes as in spicy. هيدي فليفلة حرة فليفلة okay that's how you pronounce it two syllables فليفلة. I would write it with a ف ل ي and then ف ل ت مربوطة فليفلة okay so هيدي فليفلة حلوة وهيدي فليفلة حرة. طيب okay remember this هيدي شو فليفلة حلوة okay then what's this sweet potatoes if you remember this فليفلة حلوة you can remember what's this هيدي شو هيدي يلا I'm not gonna say it who's gonna say it it's potatoes sweet potatoes كيف منقول بطاطا بالعربي منقول شو برافو سمالي بيرد okay so it's بطاطا حلوة because فليفلة حلوة is sweet peppers بطاطا حلوة is sweet potatoes بطاطا حلوة أول مرة بشتري بطاطا حلوة أول مرة بشتري بطاطا حلوة first time I buy sweet potatoes it's not like I never ate them but it's not something that I usually buy for my home so رح أعمل soup رح أعمل شوربة I'm gonna do soup so I thought فكرت إنه أحسن حط بطاطا حلوة على إنه حط بطاطا عادية so I said it's better to put sweet potatoes than normal potatoes. Okay. We have here basilic, basil. منقول حبق. نكتبها حبق مع قاف. بس منلفظها حبق. حبق. يعني basil. مش حبا. لا غلط. حبق. Okay. حبق. Basil. This is just ice. I bought it for the times I do sports or hot yoga so it's just تلج okay تلج تلج يعني ice بس كمان تلج يعني snow ice or snow تلج تلج وشو كمان في ginger بالعربي يعني زنجبيل 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 ginger ومنت جيمس is asking me شو يعني منت يعني نعنع نع هو عين ن اي ع نع نع نعنع اوكي ذاتس منت نعنع اوف بعد في شيء ايه بعد في these are peas بازيلا 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 and the flavor is دينا so cute the flavor is like wasabi flavor, okay? So how do I say some flavored wasabi flavor? We say ع, okay? مثلا, بازيلا ع wasabi, like the flavor of. So for example, if I want to say, I want vanilla ice cream, okay? I say, بدي, بوزا يعني vanilla. Yes, yes, James. بوزا يعني ice cream. بوزا ع vanilla. بوزة ع chocolate. It's not ice cream on chocolate. In this case, it means flavored. Chocolate flavor ice cream. The same thing here. بازيلا ع wasabi. Okay? You can say مع wasabi. No, it's not with wasabi. It's wasabi flavored. So, بازيلا ع wasabi. Okay, بعد في شيء. Okay, عنا هون. I personally don't say salsa. بس أكيد a lot of people in Lebanon say salsa. I say sauce. Okay? هيدي صوص للباستا or هيدي صلصة صلصة للباستا okay did we do something did we let me see if did we do خضرة مجلدة I don't even remember anyways خضرة يعني vegetables okay خضرة 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 مجلدة مجلدة يعني frozen مجلدة مجلدة so هيدي خضرة مجلدة رح حطها بالفريزر I will put it in the freezer رح حطها بالفريزر وبعرف إذا في محل I don't even know إذا هو بلا بتسيع بتسيع يعني it fits بتسيع بتسيع okay so I said بتسيع it fits في كمان ما بقى I don't know if I'm repeating them and I said them جبنة جبنة okay جبنة يعني cheese وسلطة يعني just سلطة أو خضرة you can say خضرة وفينالي this one I don't know what to call it if it's Kleenex because if it's tissues we call it Kleenex but it's not really Kleenex it's the one we clean the kitchen with so we might call it futa why because this one here I feel I'm repeating myself because I was just saying it on TikTok this one here is a futa usually the one you clean the kitchen with futa okay so هيدي If you want to refer to it as the same thing that you clean the kitchen with, you can refer to it as futa. And in the plural, it's يعني جمع futa, فوت, فوت, فوت. جمع futa, فوت, فوت. Okay? هيدا كل شيء لليوم. That's it for today. هلا أنا رح أكل. صارت الساعة 12. It's 12 o'clock almost. ورح أكل. I will eat now. بس جوعانة يعني ما كتير أكلت اليوم I didn't eat a lot today so ما علي إذا أكلت هلا وبس رح أكل رح أعمل سلاد وبنفس الوقت إذا إلي جلادة إذا إلي جلادة it means if I feel like it إذا إلي جلادة بشتغل بعد شوي لأنه رح أكتب رح جرب أكتب شوي بكتابي I will try to write a bit in my book وبس هيك before I go I want to let you know about my Lebanese Arabic 30 day challenge courses firstly thank you all for your comments and thank you for watching this I want to let you know about my whoever is doing it let the others know about the Lebanese Arabic 30 day challenge courses there's two types the pre-recorded if you need flexibility but you have also Q&A sessions my students also WhatsApp me anytime they want like we're always in contact so you don't feel left out or left alone when you're doing the course on your own. But you have the flexibility and you have lifetime access to them forever, forever. Like it's a lot of information. So if you want to learn a language, it's good to learn it with structure. And these courses are very well structured. They will literally take you from one point to another, step by step. And the next one is gonna be live. I hope if there's enough students, because after COVID, everyone's doing the pre-recorded. Because it's not easy to commit at the same time. But if there is enough people at the same time, we can do the live from June 22 until July 21. So the form is in my bio. Go ahead and fill it if you're interested. Okay? Merci كتير دينا على المساعدة. يعطيك العافية انت كمان. خليني اشوف اذا حدا عنده سؤال. Let me see if anyone has a question. I'll try to quickly skim through this. ميرسي كثير للكل عن جد و so, مثل ما قلنا apricots يعني مشمش خوخ يعني prunes اوكي شو كمان في اسمر سمرة حكينا اسمر وسمرة يعني كمان برونات بعتقد كنت عم شوف كل الكومنتات أنا وعم بحكي I think I was seeing all the comments while I was speaking Oh thank you Nina She's saying the courses are amazing and very structured They include everything from conjugating verbs correctly vocabulary expressions etc Thank you thank you thank you thank you يلا بونوي تصبحوا على خير بونوي